Good morning, everybody. We'll get that one hum out of the way, and then we'll move forward. It's good to be in God's house today. And I know that there's a buzz of excitement because there's so many good things happening this morning. First and foremost, this is a worship service, and so praise God. Praise God that we have a place like this to come and to worship for the sunshine and the gorgeous ride that we had in, for the flowers and the green grass and the leaves and all those good things. We've had a busy weekend here already. I know that yesterday at this time the yard sale was happening, and the missions team is probably resting right now because that was a lot of work. I don't know if there's any kind of a report about that, but I would be open to it if there is, about how that went. Otherwise, I just know we got rid of a lot of stuff and made a lot of money. That's what I know, and I want to thank all of the people that were involved in that. It took a large team to pull that off, and we know that we also blessed many people. Looks like about $3,500 was raised. That's wonderful. We love that. I also would like to share with you that today we have a special event as we recognize the Cub Scouts who have lined themselves up in a nice orderly fashion and who are being just so scout-like there and looking good, looking handsome and ready. We're going to recognize them in a few minutes about the work they did with Pastor Danny and with their leaders, and we're going to enjoy that as part of our worship as the scouting ministry is being highlighted this morning. I also want to tell you that somebody has to answer the question, are we going to go ahead with the baptism that's been scheduled for this afternoon? Because somebody has to say yes or no or maybe. And so I guess it's me for right now. And I'm going to say, having watched the weather the last few weekends be very nice for a while and then not be nice at all, I'm going to say, let's not cancel that. And if you're planning to be there, the address is listed in your bulletin. It's in Washington Park, and it's Rosemarie Edwards' home at the waterfront. And so that's listed in here. I would say this is the test. If there's any sign of lightning and thunder, don't bother coming. Just stay safe. Stay home. If there's any sign of lightning and thunder, by 2:45, just don't come. If it's absolutely pouring rain, don't come. If it's a little bit iffy, come on over. Let's see what happens. And we'll see what God does with that. If God wants to have the baptism today, guess what? We're going to have it. God does not want to have it. He's not going to have it, and we'll just trust that. But we will not put anybody in any kind of danger at all whatsoever. And so if that affects you in any way, that's the instructions at this point. Don't call the church office. There won't be anybody there to talk to you. And you can stop by and knock on the door at our house. I won't be there. So there are other opportunities listed in your bulletin for ministry. Many of them, different ways. The mission and the ministry are strong going into the summer. Is there anything else that needs to be lifted up from the congregation this morning? All right, let's pray. Gracious God, it is a beautiful day that you have made, and we rejoice, and our hearts are glad. I pray that you'd pour out your Spirit on us, that we would indeed worship you in spirit and in truth. I pray that as we worship, we would turn our hearts toward heaven as you have reached down to us through your Son, Jesus Christ, that we might be one, that we would abide in you in this time, that you would abide in us. Amen.
Amen. We have a theme for today, the name of God. And so you'll see that all of our songs have something to do with God's name. Let us stand and praise our Lord this morning. All hail the power of Jesus' name.
Jesus' name, let angels prostrate fall. Bring forth the royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. Bring forth the royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. Sinners whose love can never forget the wormwood and the gall, go spread your trophies at his feet and crown him Lord of all. Go spread your trophies at his feet and crown him Lord of all. Oh, that with yonder sacred throng he at his feet may fall, we'll join the everlasting song and crown him Lord of all. We'll join the everlasting song and crown him Lord of all.
Turn to your neighbor and welcome him or her in the name of the Lord this morning.
I'm
sing the heavens declare your greatness, the oceans cry out to you, the mountains they bow down before you. So I'll join with the earth and I'll give all my praise to you. So I'll join with the earth and I'll give all my praise to you. So I'll join with the earth and I'll give all my praise to you.
Let's go to the Lord in prayer this morning. There are many wonderful descriptive names that we use. Almighty, Heavenly Father, Prince of Peace, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega. But Lord, you are also our friend, our Savior. As close as our breath. May we come to know you deeper this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
Good morning. I'm filling in for Walt this morning. He is in Connecticut. He and his family are there for a family wedding and will be driving 13 hours home today. So he asked me to step in for him this morning. Good morning. A couple of things I will say. 1 year ago yesterday, Tatum and Matt, my oldest daughter, were married in front of my mom's house at 212 Riverside Drive. Of course, Danny was there and officiated over the wedding, and there was a threat of rain the whole day, and it poured about 30 minutes beforehand, and then the skies opened up, and it was just a beautiful afternoon, so hopefully that'll happen this afternoon. One other thing about my mom's 212 Riverside Drive, it is one of the homes on Riverside Drive. It is not marked by the chain link fence. For those of you that are not familiar with the park, the town of Washington Park owns the lots that are marked by the chain link fence. And her property has two large, I don't know if it's pampas grass or something, it's a huge, two huge bushes on the corners. So those are your markers. So with that said, who has some praises for us this morning? Ginger?
It was around 5 years ago this time of the year that we lost Jeff Tubaugh, and I'd just like to give praise and thanks for his life. I know that there's a lot of people in here who don't remember him or don't know him, but I've never seen a church come together like we did when Jeff was dying, and we prayed for him for many years, and even though he lost his battle, it was amazing to see God work through this church through his illness.
Seth, I'd like to say a praise for the First Christian Church, which today at 10 o'clock will have their first service in their new facility. It is gorgeous.
Others?
I would just like to praise God this morning for all of these kids that are getting baptized today, that God has touched their hearts and made them want to go through this. I also know that when you start coming closer to Christ, that the devil really starts attacking to try to make you go the other way. So I ask prayers for them today to just try to help keep the devil away so that they can live the life that God wants them to. And I ask prayers for the preteens, teenagers, and young adults.
My good friend Jack Warren lives in Wilmington.
I do want to give a praise to the Cub Scouts. You guys stick it out. I remember being in Cub Scouts at the 10th Street Church of Christ. Unfortunately, my only memory was of one of the other scouts threw a rock and hit me above the eye, and I had to get about 6 stitches. So I ended up in Boy Scouts at this church. So
I'd like to ask for prayers for our military and military families.
Are there others? I see a hand somewhere, but somebody's pointing. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Please join me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. As everybody knows, we have a strong scouting program here at First United Methodist Church because of the support of the congregation, the staff, the scout leaders, and our community. The church seeks to provide possible opportunities for worship, for study, for service, and for fellowship, and has done so with the scouting program. Scouts are busy on Mondays and Thursdays if you come to the church here. You'll see a big crowd usually, working on their achievements, doing their other activities throughout the year, such as camping, archery, science, engineering, and robotics. We are pleased that over 90% of our scouts in the Cub Scout program make their ranks yearly. Today, we take time to celebrate the scouts who have filled the requirements for the PRAY program. The PRAY program is a special award that they can get for their work in the church to study about God's Word, and Pastor Danny has helped us each year for the last 3 years work on this award. The Bible teaches us that Jesus grew and became strong. He was full of wisdom and God's blessings upon him in Luke 2:40. For the last month of the scout year, Pastor Danny has helped us with these teachings for these scouts to become better Christians. Today, the recipients are required to study Scripture and put into action what they have learned. The scouts receive an award which features a four-colored cross. The four colors converge into a point to create an X. At the center of the cross, the X is the first letter in the Greek word for Christ. And it is symbolic of how Christ should become the center of our lives. Would the following scouts please come forward? Landon Moore. Ryan Cash. Lewis Miller. Zachary Jarvis. Deason Swain. Nathan Sofer.
Eddie King. Jake Woolard. And Ian Bradbury.
Scouts, you are now holding a God in me patch, the red symbolizing love and the blood of Christ. May you always remind you that the best friends with Jesus. Eddie, you have something you want to say?
The Scouts would like to thank Pastor Danny for his dedicated service to us and for taking his time to teach us about Jesus. We love him very much and enjoyed spending time with him. We would like to present this lapel pin to thank him for his service to the Scouting program.
All right, if everybody will join me in prayer. Lord, your Son has called all of us into the adventure of learning and serving. Today we celebrate these Scouts who have answered the call in a special way, and we thank you for Scouting and for this moment of joyous celebration. Continue to challenge all of us to grow in Christian service that your kingdom may become a reality through our lives. Amen.
Hi, will all the children come forward? There we go. Okay, I'm going to share a Bible verse that some of you have probably just lived out because you got this really cool badge, but you probably didn't know you lived this Bible verse out. And it's a very well-known one. If any of you are big fans of Stephen Curry, the basketball player, this is like his favorite Bible verse. So it's Philippians 4:13, and it says this, "I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength." And I think that's a pretty important verse because some of you just got a badge. And before you got it, you're probably thinking, this is really hard. But you, what we adults like to call a big word as persevere, which means you don't give up. And you got a cool badge. And some of you had to take these end-of-year tests that are awful because you have to sit still for like 3 hours and it takes you 30 minutes to get done and you're bored. And so some of you survived that. And the teacher survived it too because after that, they got to sit there. They have nothing to do. I mean, during the test, they can't do anything. They just have to stare at the walls and make sure you don't cheat. So they even lived out this Bible verse too. And so whatever comes your way, just remember this. Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And what's really cool about Stephen Curry is he wasn't really expected to be this great basketball player. They're like, that dude's real small and tiny. He's not going to do nothing. And now he's the unanimous MVP for 2 years in a row. So just think about that. No matter what people say, you can do anything through Christ. It gives you strength. So let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for giving us your strength to do anything that we want to accomplish. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning. You didn't expect to see me here today. What a surprise. And you saw that the title of this service today is Name Above All Names. And I had some other ideas in mind that I ran by Jim prior to this and decided on this particular one about the attributes of God. And on my way here this morning, I'm listening to BBN 92.5 on the radio. What song would be playing? The last song that was played before I got out of my car was Jesus is the sweetest name I know. So it just confirmed to me that what I was about to say to you was what I was needing to say. So if you'll turn in your Bibles to the scripture for today, and it's Psalm 146. And as I read this, will you think about the ways we praise the Lord? Psalm 146. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. Do not put your trust in princes, in human beings who cannot save. When their spirit departs, they return to the ground. On that very day, their plans come to nothing. Blessed are those whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is the Lord their God. He is the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them. He remains faithful forever. He upholds the cause of the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets prisoners free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the foreigner and sustains the fatherless and the widow. But he frustrates the ways of the wicked. The Lord reigns forever. Your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. And when I thought about this, I was thinking of all the names that I have. Not all of them do I like, but most of them. So I'm mother, I'm wife, I'm daughter, I'm sister, I'm Nana. And Nana is that name that the attribute has to do with the seven grandchildren that I have. And I was so fortunate this weekend to get to go and see Hayes, our little grandson who has neurofibromatosis. And we were able to go to Kernersville and do a walk for Hayes and other children who have NF. And Hayes participated in a run, which he was the last one to cross the finish line. Didn't bother him at all. He still got the medal around his neck. He was so proud. He was beaming. And the Kernersville newspaper was there, and they took notes about him and took his picture. So I've got to go home today and look to see if his picture's in the paper for Kernersville. So being Nana is a really great name. Many of you know I also do math workshops, and so in that, I might be talking about shapes. You know all about shapes and geometry, Boy Scouts? Yeah. And so one of those shapes is a square. Think about all the names for a square. A square starts out as a polygon, a many-sided figure with straight sides. A square is a quadrilateral because we know it has only four sides. We know that a square is also a rectangle, very special rectangle, because it has right angles. We know that a square is also a rhombus because of those right angles, and it's a parallelogram because opposite sides are parallel. So how can one shape have all of those names. Amazing. God has a lot of names too. We're going to look at those names in the Bible. So if you'll turn to Genesis 1:1, and I'm certain that you know this by heart already, but we're going to look at that verse again because how precious is that verse. And Jim even referred to this today when you were talking about what you saw on the way here. And in this verse, it says, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." And so God is our creator. And the word that is used there for God's name in Hebrew is Elohim. And I think sometimes it's pronounced that way. I'm not real good at that. Elohim. So maybe you can say that with me. Elohim. And Elohim is used about 2,500 times in the Bible because it not only denotes him as creator, but also as, it was used in a plural form there. So from the very beginning, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit were in existence at the creation. And I think about our new babies, baby Ann Haven, who's here, and baby Claire, who's here, and she, I don't think she's here today, but we're so thankful for them. And I think about Psalm 139:13, that verse that talks about God has knitted you in your mother's womb. Oh my goodness, talk about creation. How precious is that? So God knew Ann Haven and knew Claire before they were ever here. And that to me, that God, Elohim, is really powerful in that. So if you'll stay in Genesis and turn to 15:2. And this is the Lord's covenant with Abram. And in that, notice his name is still Abram. He is not called Abraham at this point. But in that, verse 15:2, it says, "But Abram said, Sovereign Lord. So in that, that is the word Adonai. Say it with me, Adonai. Adonai. And Adonai is that sovereign Lord and Lord and Master. So can you say to yourself, God is Lord and Master of my life? Not only is he Elohim and the Creator, but he's also Adonai and he is Lord of my life. And that particular word is used about 439 times in the Bible. So a lot of times. So many times in prayer time, I use the word Lord and I refer to God as Lord. And sometimes I even say it, Lord. And maybe you've heard that before too. So many words for the name of God. So now I want you to look at Psalm 91:9. So if you kind of kept your fingers where the book of Psalms was, and you have to kind of turn, look, see about this far in your Bible to get to Psalms. And this is Psalm 91:1, and it says, and you're probably familiar with this verse, it's one of my favorites, "Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust." And that name is El Shaddai. You want to say that with me? El Shaddai. Don't you love that? And there's a beautiful song, El Shaddai, that we need a solo on that sometime, Scott. Such a beautiful, beautiful song. And El Shaddai is your protector. He is your refuge. So when I think about Hayes, and right now we're going through a very trying time with him because the rod that was put in his leg after that last break has slipped, has moved, and is resting on his ankle. And it's very, very painful. And they are not sure at Duke what they're going to do about that yet. They were hoping he would have a real growth spurt right away. Not sure that will happen. To move that rod, but if not, they will have to go in through his foot and push that rod up to where it needs to be. So in other words, he will have to go through another surgery. We've already been through two breaks. But you know what? He is my fortress. How can I fear anything with El Shaddai? So whether you are calling upon Elohim as your creator and thanking him for that, or if you are looking at Adonai, who is your Lord and master of your life, or if it's El Shaddai and you're calling on him as that shelter and as your refuge. So in all of those names, there's one that I know you're familiar with, and we're going to get into the New Testament with the book of Matthew. So you'll turn on over, and Matthew, of course, is the very first book in the New Testament, and we're looking at Matthew 1:23. And again, this is going to be a verse that you know well, and it says, "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel." And what does Emmanuel mean? God with us. God with us. And during Advent, we often sing, O come, who? Emmanuel. And we are longing for him to come. We are longing for Jesus with skin. Jesus with skin. And we are so grateful that he chose to leave his heavenly home and come here to be with us. And then in the book of Acts, we see Pentecost. And do you remember the Sunday that these banners were read? And I love those red ones. Too bad we don't get to keep those up very long. But those banners were for the Sunday of Pentecost when the Holy Spirit came. And that Holy Spirit resides in you and in me to convict me of my sin, to remind me. And I'm just so amazed all the time at how I run into people at different places. And all of a sudden, they're just there, and I know that's a God time because that person was supposed to be there at that time. Or how he brings to my mind somebody that I need to be praying for. Does that ever happen to you? I know it does. And that is that Holy Spirit just residing in you. So Emmanuel, love the name Emmanuel. Such a precious, precious name, and we are introduced to it right away. So, one of the names that is my very favorite is the name Abba. Because when I was a little girl, my daddy, when we got home from church, would put me on his lap and he would read the Sunday funny papers to me. And one of the comic strips when I was little was a comic strip called Little Henry. And Little Henry had frames, but there were no words. But my daddy would read it to me. How did he know what to say? There were no words. I didn't realize that until I could read, that there were no words there. But my daddy would read that comic strip to me, and I would sit in his lap, and I would call him Daddy. So the translation from Aramaic is Daddy or Papa, the most endearing term. And if you were as fortunate as me to have a loving earthly father, that you know what it's like to sit in his lap and call him Daddy. So during my prayer time, I love to imagine me sitting in the lap of Jesus and be able to look up at him and just say, Daddy, Daddy. And that word is, you've already said it today when you said the Lord's Prayer, and Scott reminded me of that. So when we say, our Father, that is the word, Abba, right there. And there are three other times in the Bible where that is. And we'll just turn to one of those. If you'll turn to... I think we'll do Matthew 14:36 since we're already in the book of Matthew 14:36. And again, you're going to know this one. I'm wrong. Try Mark. Try Mark 14:36. So the next book over, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. And this is when Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane, right before he is to be crucified. And in it, it says, going a little farther, he fell to the ground and prayed that if possible, the hour might pass from him. Abba, and your Bible probably says the word Abba. Father, he said, everything is possible for you. Goes back to what Justin was saying this morning. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will. So he was really saying, you're my daddy. You're my daddy. And you can help me. And it was not his father's will. Because we knew before Jesus ever came to earth, his father knew what was going to happen and that he was going to die for our sins. And even if it was just me, he would have died for just me. Even if it was just you, he would have died for you. And then he rose again. So perhaps we will call him Elohim, Creator, and we'll thank him for that. We'll call him Adonai, Lord, Lord and Savior. El Shaddai, your protector, your refuge. Emmanuel, what was Emmanuel? God with us. And Abba, what is Abba? Daddy, Daddy or Papa. So when you are praying, you may use those attributes, and there are so many more that we use when we're in prayer time, when we're talking to God, and when we're listening, he's talking back to us. And if you don't know him as your personal Savior, then there are just three things to do, easy as A, B, and C. Ask him to come into your life, into your heart, because you know what? He is so polite that he will not come without being invited. So invite him into your heart. Believe that he is who he says he is. He is the Son of God. He did die on the cross, and he rose again. And then see, confess your sins to him. And he will come and be your El Shaddai, your Adonai, your Emmanuel, You're Jesus, the sweetest name I know. So if you'll pray with me. Dear Jesus, we just ask that there's anyone here who does not know you as their personal Savior, we just ask that you will fill their hearts with your love and your Holy Spirit, that they will believe that you are who you say you are, and that they will confess their sins to you right here at their seats or at the altar when they join us for communion. We love you, Lord Jesus. Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus. Amen. And what a perfect time now to celebrate that special time of communion with the bread and the wine. And Jesus said, I'm giving you my broken body, broken just for you. I'm giving you the blood that I shed, and I shed this blood for you. What precious gifts. So as you are taking communion today, just thank him for what he has done for us. Jim? Sorry.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Had names for himself. One of the names that he had for himself was Bread of Life. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. So when he said, take this bread, and whenever you do it in remembrance of me, because it is my body. He meant, take me in. When he said, this is my blood of a new covenant poured out for the forgiveness of sins, for yours and for many. He meant, take my grace. This is a means of grace for us this morning. Whatever name of God needs to be your name as you come forward today, we know that it's an all-sufficient God that we serve. And you are all invited to the table. As United Methodists, we are an open table for you. Let's pray. Oh, majestic God, we celebrate you for who you are and for your mighty acts in Jesus Christ. I pray that you would pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Jesus Christ for the world, that we might be the body of Christ, redeemed by your blood, so that we might partner with you to be in service to all the world until your near return, and we feast at your heavenly banquet. In the name of Christ, I pray. Amen. You're invited to come forward as the ushers lead you. You also are welcome to bring forward your offering today and put that in the plate. If you cannot come forward and you would like to participate, please indicate so by raising your hand and an usher will come and bring the elements to you. Come to the table.
worship and adore you. Glorify thy name in all the earth. Glorify thy name.
It doesn't matter what name you call upon for the Lord. He just wants you to call Him and thank Him for all that He has done in your life. So as you leave this place, go with the peace of our Lord and Savior. In Christ's name, amen.
Yours will be the only name that matters to me, the only one whose favor I see, the only name that matters to me. Yours will be the friendship and affection I need to feel my Father smiling on me. The only name that matters to me. Yours is the name of mercy and grace, the power that forgave me, and your love is all I've ever needed.
Yours will be,
yours will be, the friendship and affection I need to feel my Father smiling on me. The only name that matters to me. And yours is the name that saved me. Mercy and grace, the power that forgave me. And your love is all I've ever needed.
When I wake up,
when I wake up in the land of glory, with the saints I will tell my story. There will be one name that I proclaim. When I wake up in the land of glory, with the saints I will tell my story. There will be one name that I proclaim.
La la.
La 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 la.
We're talking about
Jesus, 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 just that day. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Here we go.
When I wake up in the land of glory, with the saints I will tell my story. There will be one name that I proclaim. When I wake up in the land of glory, with the saints I will tell my story. There will be one name that I proclaim. La 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 la.
Everybody sing now, this is it.
La 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 la